On August 30th, at Deadly, an unexpected landslide occurred which cut off a major road and caused casualties. I am not referring to the Deadly Sudan landslide that would occur a day later, which involved volcanic rocks and mud, but rather a landslide of a completely different and, to be honest, scary origin in Norway. I say scary because the landslide in question did not occur due to volumes of rock becoming unstable on a steep slope. Rather, while this is quite an oversimplification, a patch of fairly flat ground measuring 93 meters wide and 114 meters long quickly turned from a solid mass of material to a liquid, causing this 2.78 acre chunk of land to slide as much as 600 feet into a local lake. This swept away two people, an entire car, multiple large road segments, construction equipment, and a length of railroad, causing one fatality. All of this occurred in a very short time span at a spot 41 kilometers east-northeast of the city of Trondheim in west-central Norway. The reason I am highlighting this particular landslide is it involved a type of material I have not discussed before on this channel, so-called quick clay. For reference, clay describes material with an average particle size of less than 1/256th of a millimeter or 154 millionths of an inch. But quick clay is no ordinary clay. It originally formed from long-term weathering of other rock types depositing fine particles primarily in shallow ocean environments. As the clay bound together due to flocculation, it formed fine crystals that rapidly widened as sea salt ions glued them together in a house of cards type structure. This trapped within the clay an unusually large amount of salt water which would remain for long periods of time. So long as the salt bond remained, what would otherwise be an unstable mass remained fairly stable. However, in some areas that experienced substantial levels of glaciation during the Pleistocene Ice Age, this presented a potential problem. You see, whenever large volumes of material are added to a portion of Earth's crust, it causes an imbalance that pushes the crust downwards deeper into the mantle. As a result, areas of the planet that used to be near shoreline found themselves sometimes hundreds of feet underwater during this period. Yes, this subsidence, often even in some areas, was actually greater than the actual drop in world sea levels as more of the world's water became trapped in thick ice sheets. And this is where some quick clay was deposited in a stable form. Yet, once the ice sheets greatly diminished or vanished altogether as the Pleistocene transitioned to the Holocene epoch, the land began to rise back upwards in a process known as post-glacial rebound. As a result, large areas of quick clay rose above sea level, and I think you can see the problem here. Over time, or sometimes fairly quickly if there is a triggering mechanism, the salt water within the quick clay was replaced by fresh water. This removed the salt ions that held the entire structure together. As a result, it eventually reached a point where all at once the clay collapses, turning into a sort of liquid that can take large masses of overlying land with it. This is most commonly triggered by a body of water cutting into a quick clay deposit, although it is also possible for quick clay slides to be triggered by natural overloading, earthquakes, certain very heavy rainfall events, and sometimes even rapid snowmelt. However, quick clay slides can also be triggered by some human activities such as certain types of construction and blasting. And this does not necessarily have to occur within an exposed surface layer. It can also become unstable through any of the aforementioned methods, even if it has other layers of rock or soil on top of it. As you can see, quick clay can be quite scary due to its sudden liquefaction risk, which historically speaking has resulted in a number of fatalities, such as 10 fatalities during this 2020 slide in Norway. In Norway alone, more than 100,000 people live on top of quick clay deposits. As you might have noticed, quick clay is only found in the far northern and southern hemispheres due to the conditions which created them. Some countries which contain quick clay deposits include, but are not limited to, parts of Alaska in the United States, New Zealand, Greenland, Norway, Finland, Sweden, Canada, and Chile. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, JMonte31, for supporting my work.